Shannon Tran here. So, if you have been worried about what's going on in the world right now, so as I speak, there's a lot of uncertainty. We've got this coronavirus that's just impacted the world and created all this uncertainty. And so, I want to give some support if you've just been worried about your job or your income or how you're going to provide for your family. I want to offer some hope. And so, in this video, I'm going to share 7 habits that you can implement right now and practice right now to help yourself feel safe, secure, and build that financial confidence even during uncertain times. You can really lean into some good habits that will help you manage these uncertainties. Okay, so you might gonna grab a piece of paper and a pen because you're definitely gonna want to write these down and see where you can start to implement some of these habits. All right, habit number one. Habit number one is probably the most important habit that we often forget about. I know I often forget about it. And that is really reminding yourself about where your source comes from. So sometimes we think that our source comes from our job or our boss. But on a deeper level, really what our source comes from is within, right? And our source comes from God. And if you don't believe in God, then it comes from the universe or it comes from Creator. But the point is, it's not through your job. Your job is just a channel, really, for your ability to add value, to contribute, to be able to deliver your skills in a meaningful way. And it's important to remind yourself that, especially during these scary times, we can just get caught up in our job when our job is just the source. And if you have a healthy money mindset, if that source or that channel were to dry up, you'll recreate it in another way. And this is how you'll find people pivot and be able to bring in the income they need. An example is my cousin is a hairdresser. And it's so interesting because during this time, he's actually not able to meet with people, clients online. Well, out of the blue, he came up with this idea about doing virtual haircuts. I know, I was like, what does that look like? Well, he showed me a video, and it's literally him on a call like this with his client, and he's basically telling her where to cut and giving her guidance, and she paid him. And he's had several haircuts this way just virtually, and he's gonna do color the same way. And it's amazing, right? Because that really shows you that his creativity is leading him to come up with new solutions to pivot, because working and seeing a person one-to-one is not his source. It's his ability to be creative and be guided and to have new ideas come, because this consciousness is one where he's going to be provided for and taken care of regardless of what's going on in the world. So that first habit of reminding yourself of the true source is really critical during times like this. Okay, habit number two, looking at my notes here, habit number two is about really making your money honestly. And so I know out there in the world, it's so tempting to make money quick, right? You want that quick, right? Nothing for something, those kinds of ideas. But it's about making money with integrity so you can really feel good about receiving your money. And so thinking of how you can add value to the world, what are ways that you can honestly bring prosperity into your life? And it could be creating new ideas, having new solutions, offering to barter or an exchange with someone, but really reminding yourself that money loves honesty and integrity. And so finding ways that even during the tough times where you can maintain your integrity and earn money in honest ways. Number three, habit number three is honor what you are given. So use your money in a way where it honors your values, right? For me, I tithe with every money that I earn. So my money has a job, right? My money isn't just meant to be spent. I save it, I invest it, I spend it, and I tithe it. And so in that sense, my money is blessed because it's going to places that really match with my values and what's most important to me. And If you've ever heard that saying where if you want to know what a person values, look at their bank account and how they spent their money, there's a lot of truth to that. And so what you want to see is how are you spending your money right now? Are you spending on things that really align with you and with what you value? And if not, that's one thing that you can start to change is spending your money on your top priorities right now. Okay, habit number four is save money wisely. And so learning to save and pay ourselves first, and learning to budget and live within a spending plan will help us have a lot of confidence and relationship with our money, because then we'll have money for a rainy day. It's actually raining outside, right? So then we'll have money saved for a rainy day in case of an emergency. So we're not panicked or stressed about money or living paycheck to paycheck. And so really looking at where can you save a little bit of money? And it could be you've got to be creative. It might be maybe there's some things that you're not using that you can sell, or put on eBay or something, right? To be able to create savings for yourself. Habit number five is keep good records. This is important. So, if you have a little extra time on your hands, start to really pay attention to, are you balancing your checkbook? Are you balancing your bank account? Are you writing down what you actually owe? Are you writing down what you earn? Are you looking at your taxes and really looking at where your money is going? I remember, 4 years ago when I did this, I didn't realize just how much money I spent on restaurants. It was pretty embarrassing, I admit, because I was spending almost as much on my mortgage as I was going on restaurants because I hate to cook. And when I saw that, when someone pointed out to me after getting through my embarrassment, I changed my habits and I really started to learn to enjoy cooking or get creative and do other ways so that a big portion of my money wasn't just going to restaurants or to things that I wasn't even aware of because I wasn't tracking it. So you gotta track your expenses and just pay attention to where does your money go? And it's amazing when you do that. There's been times where money showed up for me or I had the money I needed because it was an account that I totally forgot about, right? And so when you start to really pay attention and keep records for your money, you're going to feel really responsible in your relationship with money, and that's going to be very empowering, and that's going to develop your confidence in making wise choices. All right, on to let's see here, habit number six. So habit number six is have a spending plan. So I mentioned this earlier is decide ahead of time what do you need to, where do you want your money to go, right? So if you have a mortgage, that's one. If you have a car payment, that's two. Whatever it is for you, start to have a spending plan so you know exactly where your money is going. And that's the problem that I had earlier when it came to me overspending at restaurants, is I didn't have a spending plan, right? I didn't have a budget for how much I would spend on restaurants. Now I do. Now I have a monthly budget where I know ahead of time just how much I'm going to spend on a restaurant. And so then when I'm going to a restaurant, I can really splurge and have a good time. But when I hit my budget or I hit my spending plan, that means I've got to do a little more cooking. So have a spending plan for yourself, right? Because that tells your money where you want it to go. And then finally, set up a repayment plan. So if for some reason you have debt right now and or you got yourself to debt and you're scared, sit down and decide on a payment plan. Go through, okay, what do I need to pay off? And come up with a payment plan. It could be right now is a great time because people are being very flexible because of what's going on right now in the economy. And so call your creditors, negotiate with people, have a plan to pay it off so that you can really free yourself of whatever debts you need to pay off so you can really live with financial confidence. And when you practice those seven habits, you will notice an improvement in your leadership. Because our ability to master money is related to our ability to also lead our lives in a powerful way. And you may find that you start to get even better and better about saying no to some things whether it's loaning money you don't have or buying, extravagant trips that maybe aren't really going to support you right now, because overspending is not a healthy mindset habit to have. And so really look at what are some of these seven habits that you can implement right now that will help you take back your power and help you feel back in control during these uncertain times. And if you would like to learn more about how to master your money mindset so you can have a powerful relationship with money and be able to earn money in a way where you become recession-proof, reach out to me. I'd love to share with you more ideas on how you can master your money mindset. Until then, bye for now.